I took this shot while I was in Alaska in Denali National Park. Now, I'd been told at the time of year that I was going there that it's not necessarily a good time to go because you very rarely see actually Denali. But I thought, no, I'm going to go anyhow. So I went, and before I went into the park, coming from Australia, I'd heard about these grizzly bears, and I didn't know a lot about them, but I went into an outfitting store and said, look, what should I do about grizzly bears? And the guy just said, oh, you need a gun. And I go, look, mate, I'm from Australia. We're not allowed to have guns over here, you know. And I said, it's a national park. I'm not going to be taking a gun, you know. And he said, well, man, you know, they're pretty dangerous. I'm saying, look, surely there's got to be a way to deal with these bears. And he said, well, here's some capsicum spray. And he sold me some of those bells that jingle when you put them on your arms. And so off I went to the national park. And before we went into the park, we had a briefing from the ranger. And the ranger said, now look, when it comes to grizzly bears, this is what you've got to do. You know, first of all, if they're looking at you and they're sort of, you know, starting to stop and take notice, look big, look big. So I'm thinking, okay, man, I can look big. I'm a big guy. I'll look big with a pack and everything. And we were riding these push bikes into Denali, and he said, look big, step one. If they still keep coming and they charge you, just stand still. Don't move. Whatever you do, don't move, because it could be a false charge. And I'm thinking, okay, so it charges. And the thing is that now if they do keep coming, they might just be playing with you. So still act dead, act dead. I'm thinking, yeah, right, like this big bear is going to be knocking the living daylights out of me and I'm going to be playing dead. Okay, play dead. And then he said, if that doesn't work, well, I don't know what you do then. You make it up. And I'm going, great, okay. So off I go with my training on what to do with grizzly bears. So I come to this beautiful place, this wonderful lake, and I could see the chance to get a beautiful sunset and sunrise, because over there the sun would set. It was more like a sun dip, because the sunset would happen and then about an hour later the sunrise would come up again. So you could do the whole sunset, sunrise thing and go back and sleep in your tent. And so I'm sitting there watching this the sun go down and then this moon floating over this Mount Denali. And the Denali is just there perfectly, all the clouds cleared. And we're just seeing this really majestic sort of view there. And it's just so incredible. I'm going, oh God, you're just so awesome. You know, what an amazing thing. So we have this incredible experience. Now we've pedaled on our push bikes down to this location to get there. And then we went back to our push bikes. And as we were about to leave, my assistant and I, we looked over and I saw a moose, like a big moose. And, you know, I haven't had a lot of experiences with moose other than Rocky and Bullwinkle and cartoons and stuff like that. And I never realized they were so big, you know. And so I'm looking at this moose. Oh, man, he's big. And I thought, there could be a photo here because he's over near this little lake and pond. And I thought, this could be a photo. And my assistant looked at me and said, I don't know about moose, but I don't think we should be doing this. So he gets on his bike. And he takes off before we even take the camera and put it on. You know, he's meant to help me with the camera. And I'm thinking, hello, come on. And I thought, maybe he's right. So I put the camera on my bike. And the next minute, this moose starts running towards us. I'm thinking, this does not look good. And all of a sudden, you know, I can hear this thing stomping and snorting coming at me. And I'm like, huh. And I'm in the wrong gear because coming down the hill, I had it in a high gear. But I don't have time to change gears. I'm like, ruff, ruff. Pushing, and it didn't matter because I had so much adrenaline, but I'm just hearing this snorting getting louder and louder as it's coming. And if you've ever seen a moose, its headgear is so wide. It's wider than the Toyota bull bar that I've got on my, you know, four-wheel drive. And this thing's coming, and I'm just thinking, oh my goodness, what am I going to do? And I couldn't do much. I just kept pedaling, and thank goodness this moose just gave up on me. And my assistant, to give him credit, he did stop on the top of the hill to watch to see what was going to happen. So he could have at least told my wife what had happened. But anyhow, I get up the top of the hill and I said, yeah, why didn't you wait? He said, man, you know, that thing was crazy. Anyhow, we get over the hill and we meet up with the ranger who happens to be there. And he said, oh, so how are you guys going? And I said, well, actually, sir, what's the story with moose? You never told us anything about moose. And he said, well, far more people get killed by moose than grizzly bear. And I go, hello, then why didn't you tell us about the moose? So the moral of the story is, in life, you can spend your time often worrying about the grizzly bear that's going to get you, and you never have to deal with that. But it's always the moose. So, and you know what? You deal with it at the time. So I hope that story encouraged you.